can breathe. We can reset our compass. Even truthfully, to slow down enough that we can kind of appraise our life, our expression of our lives, how we breathe every day, how we work, how we love, how we serve life in this time that we're alive in the world. So that's really what's important. It's not our idea of what we may gain from retreat, or maybe lose a few pounds. Not our idea of finding peace. Not any of our ideas of what's important in our spiritual practice and so forth. What's really important is our life itself, how we live it, how we express this very life, moment to moment. That's why I think there's the reason why we're here, to come back to what in Zen we call our true nature, to bring together our most realized and authentic self. To allow ourselves to be expansive and allow all the aspects of ourselves to begin to operate in our hearts and minds. And when we're just ourselves, you know, we do express a profound humanity. We do express wisdom that arises spontaneously from that core. So we express in really kind of humble, ordinary ways. This is to be human, to just know what the appropriate action is, not in words or plans or ideas, but in our bodies, in the marrow of our bones, to truly get it. Genuine expression. That's what our study during this 90-day period is, and we'll be addressing in the talks during this 6-day session. Because every year, twice a year, we choose a study text, something for all of us to chew on and consider in our lives. And we try to find a study text that will resonate with our shuso, with our student leader for the period. As you all know, as she spoke this morning, Yuka is our shuso for this period. She's a psychotherapist and performance artist. So it seemed kind of natural for us to select the fascicle of Dogen's called Expression. Seemed to make attunement. All ways to express ourselves. So the title of this facet of Dogen's is Expression, Expressing the Truth. And in Japanese, in medieval Japanese, it's DoToKu. And it is the root of our temple name, incidentally. Village Zendo is known as DoToKu Ji, and Ji means temple. And you know, it was like 25 years or so ago. I was asked by the Soto school what was the temple name of the Village Zendo. And we'd always had the name Village Zendo, you know, kind of like by default. It's kind of like, back in those days, there was the Chelsea Zendo, and the Soho Zendo, and the Uptown Zendo, and we were by Washington Square, so we were the Village Zendo. And then suddenly we had to have a special name from Japan. As I went through the different, usually temple names have to do with mountains and so forth, I couldn't find anything. But what seemed to stick for me was running across the Dogen's fasco called DoToKu, Expressions. It literally means do, you know do is Tao, you know that. But it also is, it has synonym, it means the way, but it also means to speak. It's double meaning. And toku simply means to be able. So the toku is being able to say something with your whole body and mind, being able to express. And at the same time, it means the way. So it is being able to express the way. That's wonderful. Some other people, we usually use Kaz Tanahashi's translations most of the time here at the Zendo. He's a wonderful translator. But also other, and he translates it as expressions. But other translators say expressing the truth, or even expressing what one realizes. You know how it is, like you learn something, and you realize something, but do you express it? Or is it just a facade? Is it just an idea out there? So also, I found out when I was traveling in China, to my delight, DoToKu means a mensch. And that person isn't a DoToKu, it's a, you know, a cool person, good person. And this sangha, you know, is really a lay sangha. Even those of us who have chosen to ordain so that we can preserve some of the old rituals and so forth, still, all of us live lay lives. We live with our partners. We don't live together in a monastery or anything like that. And I always thought that that was the most authentic path of Zen for me and for those of us who practice together. That is our expression, a kind of lay life. The life of a mensch is the way I understand it. And, you know, the kind of people drawn to the Village Zendo, Robert Savage gave us the name, actually. He was the one, because he was such a slut. He went to all the Zendos in town, and he was the one that called us the Village Zendo. And he was a composer. And we've had our good share of musicians in our sangha, all kinds of creative people. Creative business people, creative therapists, it's a smile on the street, helping a hand on somebody. You know, there's so many ways to express ourselves, ways to serve the Sangha, ways to serve those in need in the jails, and every own time leaves at Sing Sing. Hospitals, the work that Jason does. And just ordinarily walking down the street, we can be expressive and we can serve. So here's the beginning of Dogen's piece. I think it speaks to this. All Buddhas and ancestors are expressions. Thus, when Buddha ancestors intend to select Buddha ancestors, they always ask, do you have your expression? This question is asked with the mind and with the body. It is asked with a walking stick or a whisk. It is asked with a pillar or a lantern. Those who are not Buddha ancestors do not ask this and do not answer this, since they are not in a position to do so. Such an expression is not obtained by following others, or by the power of oneself. Where there is a thorough inquiry of a Buddha ancestor, there is an expression of a Buddha ancestor. It's very Dogen. So I'm going to go through it line by line. All Buddhas and ancestors are expressions. Everyone who has even for a moment realized their true nature, recognized themselves, recognized their position in the universe, that is an expression, that moment. Another translation of that line is from Nirman. He says, all the Buddhas and all the ancestors express what they have realized. So the difference is very subtle between Ta-Nehisi's and Nirman's. Nirman's subject, verb, object. All Buddhas and ancestors express what they have realized. Straightforward. And helps us to understand in a direct way what Dogen's getting at. But Carlos makes the line so that we can't miss the power. All Buddhas and ancestors are expressions. And we're not talking about people over there, talking about he and you. We all are expressions. It's not that you have to find something to express, but that you are constantly expressing what you have realized. That is your expression. That's probably why we all came here, is to widen our realization so that we may express ourselves. We can offer the expression of the Buddha Dharma in these troubled times. Because each of us is already the expression of what we have realized. And the trouble is, sometimes we think that we have some idea about what our expression should be, rather than staying anchored in what we are and what we have realized. Dogen Sensei and I saw It's a Wonderful Life on the big screen at IFC the other day. I don't know, I think everyone probably has seen this in one way or another, but you see it on the big screen, new print, it's amazing. But the most moving part of that film for me was when Jimmy Stewart's character is so discouraged and almost on the verge of suicide, because he has not obtained any of his dreams. feels a complete failure. And the angel shows him what would have happened to that town if he hadn't been alive. That was so moving. Everyone would have been affected in that small town if this man who felt a failure had not been alive, had not touched the lives of all of his people. Looking for some lofty attainment, he had missed his expression, his life expression. And for me, you know, that section of the film is like the best expression of the Avatamsaka Sutra, of interpenetration of all the dharmas that I've ever seen. It's marvelous. Kind of a tearjerker sentimental thing, but got to be. The next lines here are thus. When Buddha ancestors intend to select Buddha ancestors, they always ask, do you have your expression? This question is asked of the mind and of the body. It is asked with a walking stick or a whisk. It is asked with a pillar or a lantern. So here Dogen is asking us, how do we sharpen our understanding of our expression? He suggests that we're always asking one another this. What is your expression? What are you giving off right now? Think of your ordinary life. You're walking down the street. Strangers are passing by. What is your expression at that moment? Dogen says we ask this of each other all the time with our minds and bodies. Think of our body language here. We engage each other so simply, standing in a meal line together. DoToKu. Without words, we're asking one another, what is your expression? Or Nirin says, can the sick person express their realization or not? We do, all the time. But we're not always conscious of it, of course. When we truly embody this Buddha ancestry, then we notice. So, and then we ask. Invoking all the koan stories when he says, asking the pillar or lantern. These are all the koans, the devices that the Zen teachers use to try to get somebody. Hey, wake up. Don't get caught up in the stories about the teachings and the stories about great enlightenment and great peace. But what's your expression right now? Yeah, that's what most of the Zen stories are about. And part of the charm of Zen is it's not about some idea. You know, the literature is beautiful. We like the poetry. We like to think about all of that. But it actually comes down to our expression right now as we sit here together. And, you know, when you go to work and you're working with a variety of different people, what is your expression? Express who you are in its vastness and complexity. How do you do that? The next line says, such an expression is not obtained by following others or by the power of oneself. Where there is a thorough inquiry of a Buddha ancestor, there is an expression of a Buddha ancestor. So, you know, basically, don't try to be a Zen student, or try to be a philosopher, or try to be anything. Don't try to be an ally. Don't try to be a social activist. Be a social activist. Be an ally. Express your unique way of being these qualities. So that's why I think our Shuso quoted a little bit from the Fukanzan Zengi last night. We very often talk about in Zen as well, when we come to sit together, we want to turn the light around. Meaning, look within, check in with ourselves. The path is not so much out there, but here. We prepare ourselves, and then we are at one with whatever arises outside of us. I think that's why a lot of us are attracted to the Zen forms that we use here. It's not that there's anything special about the sitting position or the bows. But they are all techniques to help us to realize ourselves. So you have to sit still. Otherwise, you're going to distract yourself constantly. So this is the various positions that we have, moving, chair sitting, and so forth, are all based on finding a position so you're not going to distract yourself. Or the person next to you, right? The bows, you know, I mean, the physicality of, you know, I always think of like big head, full of ego. Here, I'm going to put that down a little bit lower than my butt. Humility, connecting to the whole world. It's crucially important. The forms that we hear, you know, they're nothing holy. They're just frameworks. Techniques, physical techniques for us to realize ourselves. Dogen says, or by the power of oneself. Such an expression is not obtained by following others, so the forms are not about that, or by the power of oneself. This can help us to remember not to try to do anything with ourselves. Not try to fix ourselves. Like Jimmy Stewart's character wanted to be a great architect. But it turned out that, you know, he was responsible for the vitality and morality of that town. Running a savings and loans association. Allow our realization to emerge from our circumstances. Just that intimacy of allowing ourselves, letting go of all the structures in our mind, ought to, should. Walls of the mind, as a Sanskrit has it. To simply allow the intimacy of the self to shine forth. I think that's our job here the next few days. Come back to ourselves. Allow the walls of the mind to drop away. To let all our goals and opinions, our reactivity, to just drop away for a little while. Freshen ourselves. What would be left? Dogen wrote a poem about what would be left. And the name, the title of this poem is Soto Zen, the treasury of the true Dharma eye. Here's the poem. In the heart, not by the waves, nor swayed by the breeze. We can make our retreat such a drifting boat. We're opportunity is an experience, an opportunity for you to experience yourself in a new way, fresh. Maybe drifting in an eddy on the Hudson River. Just imagine that. Not tossed by the waves or the breezes, but at peace with the intimacy of yourself, your own being, your own expression. So I hope this retreat will serve you. I hope this retreat